shoot all arms. Hop into it, take your time, make your shot. Follow through.
If I'm not working, someone's working harder than me.
I think I learned how to work when I got to the league. I didn't really understand how hard I had to work before. So I instilled that in Jalen, you know, at a young age to kind of eliminate the fact of just trying to make it every year. I think he put himself in a great position. The credit goes to him. He put the work in. I gave him the blueprint, but he did it.
When Michael Jordan played with the Wizards, and we went in and he asked to get a Michael Jordan jersey. So I bought him one. One of the players or coaches asked if he wanted to go in the locker room. There's just an uproar, and when he comes out, they come out and say, "You won't believe what your son just did." And Michael Jordan asked him if he wanted him to sign the jersey, and Jalen said, "No, you'll mess it up." He just was a true fan and, you know, a kid, honest. He just didn't know.
I knew Jalen wasn't one and done. Just the type of guy, the type of player he's going to be, just wasn't ready to be that type of kid. So we got here, we had a 3-year plan. And I told Jay Wright, I have 3 years for him to graduate, for him to win this national championship, and then he's going to get out of here. That was our whole plan the whole time.
Well, a lot of people talk about a 3-year plan. You know, we have it for a number of players. Very few complete that 3-year plan. And even after his second year, we thought, all right, he's good enough to be an NBA player. And we had a meeting with Rick and Sandra, and it was real simple. Sandra said, I want him to get his degree, and he wants his degree. And Rick said, I want one more year. He needs to get a year better.
You know, honestly, I have the confidence that I can, if I set my mind to something, I'm going to do it. And I mean, that's just the confidence I have. But I knew my dad's never steered me wrong from anything. And everything he said throughout my career has come true. Just from me working hard and not really focusing on, you know, the outcome, just always focusing on getting better every day. And so I trust my father, I trust my parents, because everything they said has come true.
I've never seen anyone at Villanova graduate in 3 years, let alone a student athlete or a national player of the year caliber athlete. So watching this process was amazing. It was a lot of difficult decisions he had to make, loading up in the summer, declining going to the sneaker company's camps where you're seen by NBA scouts, to stay and make sure he was on time to graduate in 3 years. So there were a lot of sacrifices. It was incredible to watch the precision, the commitment, the work ethic, and really the sacrifice.
Balancing academics, you know, during the season is tough. I was up early in the morning, I was up late at night, and I was just trying finding times where I had time to study.
Looking back and seeing what Jalen's accomplished and reaching his goals and graduating in 3 years, it's remarkable. I have to pinch myself sometimes. As a parent, you know, you teach your children and you preach, you know, work hard, be disciplined, do the right thing, and so forth. And I find myself thinking, wow, he actually listened. You know, wow, he actually did that. And he did it flawlessly with respect of, you know, not missing a beat. He's an example of just pure dedication.
Junior year was not surprising. I don't think anyone on the outside thought we were going to do what we did this year. But for me, I had goals written on my wall from the first week of first semester, my junior year, and I had the East Player of the Year, Big Five Player of the Year, National Player of the Year, Big East Tournament Champions, NCAA Champions. I mean, I had goals written on my wall because I knew what we were capable of, I knew what I was capable of. And I just tried not to focus on myself, just focus on the team and what the team needed, and you know, we achieved those goals.
Probably the biggest obstacle for him was not being the go-to guy. For his first 2 years, he didn't have to be the go-to guy, but when we needed him to, he was always there. In his third year, he was the go-to guy, and then the obstacle was, how do I make sure I'm the go-to guy and I keep everybody else involved? He is a natural killer. He wants all the weight on his shoulders. So when you need him to do it, he does it. he'll do it and also make everybody else look good while he's doing it.
He's human. He's heard and read and about, you know, he's not an athlete, too small, too slow. He's heard all that. But like I keep saying to people, he's one of 8 people in the history of Illinois to win over 100 games in high school. He's won over 100 games in college. He won 2 gold medals. So at the end of the day, you keep doubting him, he keeps winning. You keep doubting him, he keeps getting player of the year. You keep doubting him, he's a McDonald's All-American. So that's the motivation of what people keep saying. But at the end of the day, all that matters is what I say, what his mom says, and what he believes in.
We always take pride in the guys in our program, and I feel like he is the combination of Randy Foy, Kyle Lowry, the best of both. The intelligence, the toughness, the skill, the leadership.
One thing that separates great players from good players is their detail, the detail to little things. And those great players, they really, you know, take pride in just watching film, you know, watching what they eat, and making sure they're in the best shape of their life, just to get that edge. A true believer is just being able to believe in yourself, being able to believe in the process, you know, what you're doing is the right thing for you. I have the answers to the test. They're in my back pocket. I just need to be able to study them and know that I'm gonna do well in this test as long as I look at them.